going to do a Chit Chat GRWM with me. It's been so long since I've done one, so let's get into it. First thing, I'm gonna prime my face with my Instablur primer from the Body Shop. It's been so long since I've done one of these videos. It feels like forever. I don't really know if I have anything really like exciting to tell you, but we're just going to talk. Next, I'm gonna use my Prep+Prime CC cream from MAC. This is a Neutralize one, and I think I use this in literally all of my videos at the moment because it just really, it's a really good primer, but it also like hides any redness in my skin. So I really like that. And I don't know what's going on with my skin at the moment, but I've just had some breakouts, or it's not really like sits or pimples because they're not like yellow, but it's just been like irritated skin, and I don't know if it's because of the season, you know, because it's turning into winter and so on, and my skin might be a bit, irritated. However, this cream is really good because it really like evens out my skin tone much more. A while ago, Gosh Cosmetics, which is a Danish brand, sent me some makeup products from their like fall autumn collection, and I haven't really been able to try them out yet because I've had so many other products to try out, but I'm gonna test all of them today, so it's also going to be a first impressions get ready with me video. But the thing I'm gonna try out is their mineral powder, and I think this is going to be like a foundation and a powder in one. Hopefully this is the right shade. They just sent me some colors, so hopefully this is going to be the right shade. It is in the shade 004 Natural. I don't know, but we'll have to try and see. I think I'm just gonna use my MAC Kabuki brush, and then let's see. I have no idea what to expect when it comes to like coverage or color match. It seems to cover like redness pretty good. That's a really good thing right now. Thoughts on the mineral powder is that it looks really good. It's really evened out my skin tone so nicely. The color seems to be okay. The only thing I don't really like about powders or mineral powders in general is that those that I've tried, and also this one, they seem to look really powdery, obviously, and I am not really that much into that matte powdery finish, but yeah, it's okay. I think it's got a really nice coverage level, like a medium coverage, because it has covered like my spots on my cheeks and so on, so, and redness gone, so really high coverage, actually medium to full. Definitely buildable, not creasing or cracking. I do like it. Just gonna use a tiny bit of concealer because I just have to. How to conceal like those small things that irritate me about my skin. And as I tried to say earlier, I've had some troubled skin lately, not quite sure why, but it is starting to fade away, and either it's because of the season, because the weather is changing, or else I've tried out so many new, like, 2 seconds, I'm just gonna get a brush. I'm just gonna use my Cool Curves foundation brush to blend it in. But I've also tried so many, like, new skincare products lately, and maybe my skin has reacted to that and been like, that is not good for me. I'm not sure what has gone wrong with my skin, but it is getting much better. I've left all of those like new skincare products that I've been trying out, and now I'm just using like my Elizabeth Arden 8-hour cream for my face and my Estee Lauder Night Repair Serum. I'm just basically using all of those products that I am 100% sure is good for my skin. It has really helped my skin and cleared out my skin much, much, much more. So my skin does look a bit better. Not completely like itself yet, but we're getting there. I'm gonna conceal and highlight under my eyes with my L'Oreal. I also use the L'Oreal, what's it called? True Match Correcting Concealer. So this is in the color one Ivory and the other one was in Vanilla. But yeah, what else has been going on? I've had my birthday on the 10th of November, which was a really nice day. I spent the day with my family and it was just a lovely day. Also, this Sunday I'm actually going to a concert with my family. You probably all know the band, it's called Beach Boys. Would it be nice if we were old and everyone had to wait so long? Oh, I love them so, so much. I remember I watched the movie 51st Dates, and that was when I, like, for the first time really, like, heard the music and so on. And I just love the Beach Boys so, so much. I think they're so cool. I love the vibe. I love the music. It is very, like, oldies and kind of fun and cheeky and so on. And that's what I really like about it. So I'm so excited for that. And as I said, I'm going with my family. So my mom, my dad, my sister. And we're just going to have an amazing Saturday. And yeah, I think it's going to be so much fun. I'm thinking about wearing like a beach dress, something like that, just totally in the spirit. Next, I'm gonna use my Pro Longwear Paint Prep from MAC in the color Soft Ochre as a base for my eyeshadows. Kind of forgot about this for a while because I got my Smashbox Photo Finish Lip Primer back, but this is still one of my faves for like, an eye primer, also because it's got that yellowy tint to it, so it really just cancels out any red veins or blue veins on my eyelids. Let's zoom in and do the brows. I'm gonna use my Archery stick from Soap and Glory, and I've actually ordered a new Anastasia Brow Wiz pencil for my brows because I can't deal with it anymore. I can't live without it. I need a new one back in my life. So yeah, that's what happened. Also, to all of you Danish followers out there, if you haven't heard already, Urban Decay has come to Denmark. You can now buy it either in Magasin in Copenhagen or else online on magasin.dk, which is so nice. I am so excited about that. And when I found out, I was just like, finally. Finally, you can actually get it in Denmark. That is so nice. I just feel like so many things have happened lately. Like, there's been so much going on. And also, can you believe that it's almost Christmas? Oh yeah, and speaking about Christmas time, here on my channel, I am not going to be doing, like, Vlogmas. I know a lot of big YouTubers, they do, like, Vlogmas where they vlog every day till Christmas. However, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do it a bit differently. I am going to be doing a video every day till Christmas, but it's not going to be only vlogs. So I'm going to be doing all kinds of different videos where I tell you about my Christmas experiences and my traditions, and also share with you like my favorite Christmas movies and also like my Christmas must-have, stuff like that, just everything Christmassy really. So it's going to be like an almost like an advent Christmas calendar in a way, and I hope that you're going to like that. So I thought that was kind of like different and also, I don't know, maybe a bit more interesting for you guys to see and hear about my Christmas. I think I'm also going to do like one or two vlogs, but I'm not going to be vlogging every single day. To set my brows, I am going to use the Gush Defining Brow Gel. I talked about this one before because A, it has been one of my like favorite brow setting gels for a very long time. But this one is actually a new one. This is with a tint in it. So this is with the tint 003. It looks kind of dark. Hopefully it's not going to be too dark. But we'll see. I'm just going to use it in my brows to set them. that is actually kind of nice. I really like this one with the tint in it. It doesn't make my brows like too brown or too dark, but it really just like fills in the sparse areas and it looks kind of good. For my eyeshadows, I'm also going to be using something new from Cosmetics. This is the 9 Shades Shadow Collection. This is to enjoy in New York. So you get 9 different colors, and most of them are like cool toned, I would say, and they are very purpley, and yeah, I think they're pretty. You've also got some highlighting shades, some brownie ones as well, so this is nice. It's a nice color section. Firstly, let's warm up the crease. Let's take this one here. Let's see how the pigmentation is. I like that it comes with a huge mirror as well. Pigmentation is good. I would say most of the colors in this palette, they are like semi-matte with a satin finish. They are not completely matte, any of them, but they're not like really shimmery either. So they're somewhere in the middle. I would say a satiny finish on the lips. And all over the lid, I'm gonna go for this color here, which looks like a bit of a like deeper champagne-y color. And this is a bit more sparkly. One thing about the shadows is that they're very like powdery. They're not like buttery in texture. So they do have a tiny bit of fallout. But else, I do find that the pigmentation is quite good on these shadows. Just to run under my eyes, I'm gonna go for the darkest color down here. A dark brown one. Just to get a bit more smoky. To highlight in my inner teardrop area and also under my brows, I'm gonna use this color up here, which has got a bit of like a pinky undertone in it. This is like a really straightforward, not difficult at all makeup look. Once again, great pigmentation actually. Then I'm just gonna curl my lashes. I don't wanna go in with an eyeliner or anything like that. I just want this look to be very, very basic, very simple. No fuss, no anything. Also from Gush, I got this new mascara. This is the Double Precision Mascara in the color 001 Black. Okay, so it looks like this, and it's kind of like double-ended. So the first one here is Double Precision Mascara for the lower... This is double-ended. Okay, so you've got one end for the bottom lashes and one for the upper lashes. That is so smart. We'll see how that goes. Gonna start with my upper lashes. Let's see the brush. Looks like that. Let me give you a close-up. And that was the upper lashes, and now for my bottom lashes, the wand looks like this. So it's a bit smaller and also a bit thinner and more like tight in the bristles. So honest opinion on the mascara is that it looks actually pretty good. But it is not a mascara that I would be reaching for on an everyday basis, because it takes such a long time to build up the product. And also the consistency of the mascara is kind of gloopy. The finished result is kind of good. My lashes are separated and long, and yeah, it just took a really long time to build up the product. Moving on to my cheeks, I've got a Gush Giant Blush. In the color 06 Pink Parfait, which is a cream blush, as you can see. I'm just gonna apply and then gently work it in with my finger. And on the other side as well. So it was actually really easy to blend in. I think it looks pretty, it looks very natural. A pretty pink color for the cheeks, definitely. For bronzer, I'm gonna use my Urban Decay Naked Flushed palette, and I'm gonna use the bronzer in this one, which is that one. So I'm gonna use my NARS Eater brush. Long time since I've used that one. And temples as well as my forehead. And contour my nose on the sides. And to highlight, I'm gonna use this color in the middle. And I'm using my fan brush from Cool Colors. Up here. And for my lips, let's just go very, very basic. I'm gonna use a Tanya Burr lip gloss. This is in the color Afternoon Tea. Makeup look for today, guys. So this was my Chit Chat Get Ready With Me / first impressions video, and I really hope that you liked it and enjoyed it. Please let me know and give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And else, I just want to say thank you so much for watching and have the most amazing day. Bye!